All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Jim Greig, the president of Benchmark Metals. And Jim, welcome back. Nice to see you again.
Good to see you, Steve.
So big announcement out from the company, a $40 million bought deal. First off, just give me some general thoughts about being able to bring this amount of money into the project.
Yeah, look, this large funding that we did enables the company to move ahead much quicker, but also complete all the goals that we've lined out over the past year. So a $40 million raise is a large sum of money, but that enables us to advance all the engineering and technical efforts to complete a feasibility study for near the end of 2022.
So would that be the main focus of the work that you're going to be doing over the next, first half of 2022?
Yeah, that's right. There's three large milestones into 2022, and that includes an updated resource estimate based on all of the drilling that's been completed this year. That will be followed by a preliminary economic analysis. And then for the tail end of next year, a feasibility study, which at that point is a go-to-mine decision.
Okay. We should also mention that you also had some investment from Yamana, who has been a big supporter of this project. Can you talk about that part of the fundraise as well?
Yeah, the investment from Yamana validates the company and the project on a exponential basis, if you will. Yamana Gold is a world-class miner that operates in tier one safe jurisdictions where very good margins are made on their metals. They've invested 4% equity ownership into Benchmark Metals. This validates our project. They performed due diligence. There was interaction with management. We had some serious meetings disclosing all the details of the project. And they've spent $8 million into Benchmark. And this is a serious endeavor and, brings us into the realm of perhaps a new company taking over Benchmark into the future, if it's not Yamana, and they invest in companies that they only believe in and have serious technical merits. But I think this will also open the eyes of other mining endeavors that Benchmark is working towards a world-class mine.
Just on that, Jim, obviously everyone saw the Kinross deal with Great Bear Resources. Is that kind of interest in the mining industry in Canada, even though it's in Ontario and you're British Columbia, but still it puts eyes on Canada, which I think is always important for a company, especially one that has a project like Benchmark?
Yeah, you're quite right, Steve. Canada is a safe tier one jurisdiction. You can permit mines in Canada. You can make very profitable mines in Canada, but it's geopolitically very safe. It's a rule of law here, democratic. Everyone understands the corporate tax structure. These companies are now looking back to North America and the Western world to develop mines. And that Great Bear Kinross endeavor goes to show that merger and acquisition activity is increasingly, it's increasing right across the board because the mines need to replace their inventory and they have not done so over the last 10 years. So the explorers are now becoming something for investors to look out for because there's a premium offered. And, the mines are a bit like a grocery store. When the shelves become empty, you've got to replenish them. And that's the state we're at in the industry.
Yeah, there you go. You're sort of the supply chain, so to speak. So that's there you right. go. Yep. Jim, thanks very much. Great to see you again. Congratulations on this. And if I don't see you before the holidays, have a happy holidays with you and your family.
Very good. Safe holidays to you, Steve.
All right. There's Jim Greig, the president of Benchmark Metals.